over his revelations. God had given such tremendous blessings to the Apostle Paul. And the scripture says there in the 12th chapter of 2 Corinthians that Paul had actually been caught right up into the third heaven. And he stood in some horrible sense. He wasn't sure himself precisely the nature of the experience. He stood in some horrible sense in the very presence of God. And God had spoken in revelatory truth, and he inscripturated it in the pages of scripture. And so Paul was kept from conceit over these powerful and mighty revelations by the humiliation of what he calls a thorn in the flesh. And then he says to us, that thorn in the flesh was given me, lest I should be exalted above measure. It was a deterrent to pride. Sometimes that's why God sends adversity into our lives, to keep us humble, to make us remember the source of our blessing. Source of our power. Can you imagine what it must have been like for the Apostle Paul to, in some sense, stood in the very presence of God in the third heaven? He was caught up to the third heaven, the scripture says, the very abode of God. No wonder Paul was such a full church for the glory of God. Could there be anything on this earth that would attract a man once he stood in the very presence of God? Are there any riches on this globe that would be attracted to a man who stood in the very presence of God and seen the riches of heaven? Is there any position of power that a man would want to pursue apart from the will of God on earth after he stood in the very presence and power of God Almighty? No wonder Paul was such a flame, dynamic torch for the glory of God in his ministry. But there was an occasion to pride because of those mighty revelations that God had given.